Go, testing, testing.
Right then, this is Sheila. I'm now on a Burrough Green walk. It's supposed to be, if you want to do the whole thing, it's 6 miles. It's a circular walk and it brings you back this way. I don't know whether I do that, because I don't like, I get worried by weather. I do get worried by weather, and I don't put my Mac in. Too much to carry, I've got to carry everything with me as it is. And I've done part of this, I've just gone past a thistle field where you use a nice view of Burrough Green, St Augustine's Church, but I'm now following a predetermined walk that's been organised and designed by other people. Right, so when we get to this bridge, set off from the village, emerge to sit path onto. Emergency path alongside hedge to left, leading on downhill. Obvious path to right. Follow this path and swing left with it. Pass inside a wood and soon out to emerge onto road. I'm now walking. There is some yellow arrows that I'm following. I think it's probably up past two the time. So it takes 3 hours. Plus two, plus three, plus four, plus five I get back. Anyway, not to worry about rain or anything like that. This is Sheila out in the countryside, surrounded by the fields of her ancestors. I picked some barley or whatever it is, wheat, I'm not sure what it is, the other day to bring back some fresh. So I'll keep the old, but if there's somewhere around here, my ancestors, the oaks, had a wood. So if I'm going to come back that way, it looks like it. I mean, all I've got to eat is, there could be a chocolate biscuit in there. I've definitely got biscuits. I've definitely got cake. I've got cartons of orange and a small bottle of water. I don't feel hungry at all. And I do want to explore my ancestral lands. Of course, I don't tend to walk very quick, so I don't know what speed they're basing it on. 6 miles. So this is Sheila. As opposed to Somerset, this is Sheila's Suffolk walk. I wanted to do one. It's a pity I couldn't video it. That'll keep for another time. I'm surrounded by yellow corn, or wheat, or whatever it is. I'm going for a walk, but my bag is really heavy, because I've got to carry I've got water, juice, I've got to carry all my belongings, really, because you can't even, it'd be terrible if someone in the car, because I've got all those tape cassettes, and dozens of cameras. You can't replace that. That would be destroying, to be quite honest. I just hope I locked it then. Yeah, I must have done. Right then, I'm turning off now while I keep a bit of tape. I'm hoping, well, I expect the church will be shut by the time I get back. I'm not sure what I'm doing as for going back to Somerset yet. I really am restricted to what I can do, apart from going for walks. And it's going to cost me another £14 if I stay tomorrow night. So I'm really trying to weigh up whether I should go back tomorrow. That saves me £14. You know, I can put that towards petrol. I've done an awful lot of stuff. I do feel exhausted. He said I didn't have to rush to get back. I mean, the only thing I wanted to do by getting back on the Sunday was to avoid all the people. Like, I've got to unload all my stuff and that. Do you know what I mean? Where I live gets very busy at night. Lots of drunken people around. But then if I did get back, unload somehow or other, go and park the car in a safer place, I could then possibly take Zara and Brandy out for a little drive, because I mean, that's a bit sorry like that really. But I don't know how she'd handle it. She'd have to sit in the back with Maggie, make sure she don't scratch nothing. That's the only other problem we've got. Well, I presume I'm going the right way. I might not be going the right way, you know, after all that. Well, I am following a yellow arrow, but I thought I'd be walking closer to the woods somehow. Let me have a look again. So bring the chin after right, won't it? Head down the field with a hedging left. Emerge to see a path alongside hedge to left, leading on downhill. Emerge to see a path alongside hedge to left. Ignore obvious path to right. Follow this path and swing left with it, passing side of wood, and soon after emerge onto a road. Well, I'm going across another 44 point. So I can see a road. Of the wood, there's a sort of a ditch going around it as well. This big wood was probably owned by the one that's owned by my oak ancestors. And like I said, the only way to really get the feel of a place and the relationship of everything to everything else, for example, one village to another, where people would walk. We never had cars or nothing like that in those days, or bicycles. You know, again, they would have horses. So they would have to walk this. So this is probably an old route that takes you to one village to another. They would walk this, and I can imagine my ancestors. It's going to be more than 200 years. I'm talking about definitely 200 years. When Edward Oak was a young man, and his father Stephen was a farmer here, it'd be nice to know which field they owned, wouldn't it? Now, I wonder if this is a different road to the one I... Is that the road I remember when I was driving was, full of corn, maize, green, it was green. Whereas the road following here, so this must be a different road.
I put more photos on.